We have somebody naked in Florida. Let's see what's going on here.
We were asleep in bed, and all of a sudden we heard banging at the front door.
Uh-oh.
And then the doorbell ringing over and over and over.
That's how Laurel Walker says she was awoken shortly after going to bed.
So I told my husband to get his gun, and I was going to call 911.
Yeah.
A man who was naked swam from the boat ramp next to Clark's fish camp.
Right, we have a naked guy,
ran up the Walker's dock and was now standing outside their door.
Naked guy outside door. That's got to be scary as hell. To be woke up in the middle of the night by a naked guy outside.
I yelled
right
down to the front door and said, "Who is it?"
Yeah.
And he said, "My name is Jonathan Foss.
Okay.
Please let me in. The demons are chasing me."
Oh, no. Oh, no. The demons are chasing him? Did the demons take his pants, too?
They ate his clothes.
Is that what you think happened here? The Florida demons were chasing him and ate his clothes?
29-year-old Jonathan Foss was arrested last summer for trying to steal prescription drugs from the Walmart store on Racetrack Road.
So he gave her his real name and everything like that and just said, "Hey, demons are chasing me. I gotta get in the house."
At the time, he told authorities, quote, "I'm in heaven."
Yeah.
During the incident, he was tasered 5 times to no effect.
All right, so that's
my man's been on the wrong stuff a couple times.
Yeah,
here.
That's the rap sheet on this guy.
And was finally wrestled into handcuffs.
Yeah. After several unsuccessful attempts to break into the home, Foss resorted to the doggy door.
Now that does you gotta be on
a grown ass man.
You gotta be on some real crazy drugs. You gotta be taking the hard drugs to think as a grown man you can fit through a doggy door.
Where he was eventually captured by police.
By the way, naked too.
Naked.
Maybe that's what he thought. Maybe he thought, like, you know, I'm sweaty a little bit, I'm naked, maybe I can lube myself enough to get in the doggy door.
So he was able to get his head through the door and then one arm through the door.
I want to see it.
You ever see a gif of like a fat cat that gets stuck in the doggy door? Like, that's what this guy was.
But the, like,
naked ass and all just hanging out in the yard.
I feel like the fat cat going through the doggy door, like when you see clips of that online, I feel like the fat cat has a chance.
The fat cat believes he can get through, too.
Like, you're watching it because you eventually think somebody's going to push the fat cat from the other end because the fat cat's in the doggy door too far. This guy, though, it's a grown man. There's no chance he's fitting through the doggy door. I'm actually impressed that he got his head and one arm through it, you know?
And from there, my husband asked him to turn around and look at him.
Yeah.
So he twisted through the doggy door and looked up at my husband. He said, "You do see I have a gun." He said,
I mean, what a moment that has to be, right? So the guy says, "Look up at me." This guy's in the house. The naked guy who's got his head and one arm through the doggy door then has to turn his body around in the doggy door and look up. And this guy's just got a gun pointed right at him.
"Yes, sir. I see you have a gun, but I'd rather you shoot me than leave me out here to be eaten by the demons."
All right, listen. We bring up stories like this because they're crazy, they're out of control. This is a Florida story, but also as an educational tool. I'm telling you, don't do the hard drugs.
No.
Do you want to end up like this?
Stuck in a doggy door?
Do you want to end up naked in a doggy door?
Half your part still outside?
For this?
"Please let me in. The demons are chasing me."
You don't want to ever be naked in a doggy door, right? But you never want to be naked in a doggy door saying this to the homeowner.
"Please let me in. The demons are chasing me."
Don't do the hard drugs. Florida making the show once again.